How to run Playwright Java tests on Jenkins. Here's today's starting point. I have a Jenkins LTS controller version 2.440.2. Attached to this controller, I have a Mac OS based agent. Now there's also a sample repository for this video. The link to that repository is down in the description. Let's go and take a look at that repository. What we have is a basic Maven project. In fact, we'll go ahead and take a look at PomXML. What we have here is we have a dependency on JUnit and also on Playwright. So if we go ahead and take a look at our tests, what we'll see here is we have a Jenkins configuration test. So for this test, what I'm doing is I'm going to be starting up Playwright and doing a login and logout against a Jenkins controller. So if we take a look at our example code, we have a before all for setting up our runner. So we have all the information that's going to be run once just for this test run. And then we also have a before each. So we're going to open up the browser. So again, we get everything ready one time at the very beginning. Then also in this case, what we're going to be doing is we're going to be logging into the controller. Now again, for this example, it's very trivial. I only have one test case, but you'll also notice here that I have a write video. So what I actually have is I'm going to be capturing all the videos that we run and they're going to be attached to the job. So what does that really look like? Well, let's go into our Jenkins file and see how this is going to run. You'll notice here that we have two environment variables, the test Jenkins URL, and then also the test login. So what I'm providing here is the URL that we're going to be testing against and also the credentials that we need in order to log into that controller. Now, where are test Jenkins URL and test login used? Well, we're using the credentials helper for test login. So that's going to mean that we're going to be getting two extra environment variables, a test login underscore USR and a test login underscore PSW. Let's go back over and take a look at our test again. If we take a look at the setup here, what we see is we are getting the environment variable test login user USR and assigning it to login username. And also for login password, we're getting test login PSW. And then we're also pulling in the test URL from the environment variable. So we're using these three environment variables to help drive what's happening overall for this job run. But you'll also notice here that we had a couple of other environment variables. We're using viewport height and viewport width. Well, how are we using that? If we go back over to our Jenkins file, what we're going to see is that for each stage that we're running, we are specifying, except for this first stage, the viewport width and height. That way we can record different versions of the videos with a different size of the video. So in this first one, we're running the test for 1280 by 720. But notice I'm not specifying any environment variables. Well, if we go back over into our test case, what we can see here is that the default is 1280 and 720. So I don't need to specify it for that. But once we get back into our Jenkins file, we're going to run it for 1920 by 1080. That's a standard desktop screen size. But then I also run it for portrait sizes. So think about a phone. So I have two different phone sizes that I'm running here as well. So each time these tests run, a video is going to be recorded of the login and the logout. And then once everything is done at the end, and once it's all successful, then I'm going to be copying all the files that we're capturing in the videos folder. They're all WebM files, and we're going to copy those archive artifacts back over into our controller. Now, how do I know that videos is where I want to grab that? We'll go back into our test and take a look at the location for our videos. When we take a look at Open Browser, we're setting up a context that's based on the browser that was defined in our before all. And then here, we're setting the record video directory just to videos. So that's going to be inside the workspace of our job run. So we log in and log out. Now I want to call out one more thing that I'm doing here, and this is on purpose. Notice that I'm setting a timeout for 2 seconds. If I didn't set a timeout, the video runs by so fast, it's hard to see exactly what happens. So I'm adding in timeouts specifically so that when the video plays back, I can look at it and understand, okay, yep, I got there, and then it's all done. So that's why the timeouts are there. You may not need timeouts in your test cases. In fact, if you're not recording video, it would be best to not add the timeout. The reason why I'm using timeouts is purely for looking at the videos after they're recorded. So enough talking, let's go ahead and run this and see what happens. Let's go back over to our controller. I've already set up the job. The job is pointing at our Jenkins file within this repository. Let's go ahead and click on Build Now. Now that the job completed, we can see everything ran fine and we archived the artifacts. Well, let's go back into job one and we can see our artifacts are attached here. So if I go ahead and click on this artifact, what we're going to see is the video starts up. We can see that we're logging in. And then once we go up and click log out, we go back to the login screen. So this is my 1280 by 720. That worked fine. If we go ahead and run this again for our 1920 by 1080, then we can see the screen looks a little bit wider and we can see more information. But then once it finishes up, we get back to the login screen. We'll do one of the mobile sized screens. We'll take a look at the 1080 by 2340. Now we can see it gets cut off a little bit because my screen doesn't handle that as well. But then once it renders out, we finally see the login screen again. So we know that we're able to go ahead, run all of our tests, capture all those videos, and still see all the output that we were expecting to see. If you have any questions or comments, you can reach out to us on X at CloudBees. If this video was helpful to you, give us a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed to CloudBees TV yet, why not? Take a moment, click on that subscribe button, and then ring that bell, and you'll be notified anytime there's new content available on CloudBees TV. Thanks for watching, and we will see you in the next video.